That was the scene in Kabul, Afghanistan. NPC has verified the video, which shows Afghani soldiers firing into the air in an attempt to push the crowd back from the airport as people are desperately trying to get out of that country. There was another terribly tough image today. This one was in the New York Times showing a baby being handed to U.S. Marines in hopes of getting the child out of the country. The only good news we can share from that photo is that child has been reported by the Marines to be safe with their family tonight. It has been, as that picture shows, a nightmare for days for the people of Afghanistan, many leaving the only homes they ever knew trying to get out, others hiding in their homes waiting to see what their country will become. Afghan Americans with family caught there are watching this unfold completely helpless. I talked to one today from her home here in the metro.
So historically, Afghanistan has been at war.
Amina Baha has cousins, aunts and uncles, and a mother trapped in their homeland.
One day I wake up, the Taliban are taking province after province. The next day I wake up, the president is gone. Then I start to see people trying to flee the Taliban. And then just the last 2 days, I couldn't get a hold of my mother.
Her mom's cell phone data plan ran out. In Afghanistan, they don't have phone contracts like you and me. They have cards that buy time. But with the country in chaos, the cards are gone. Amina figured it out and put time on her mom's card last night.
She's okay right now. She's with family and she's in Kabul. Kabul is a little bit more safer compared to the rest of Afghanistan, but we don't know for how long.
And they don't know how they'll get her back. Just one more worry on top of so many.
What gets me so emotional and almost makes me cry sometimes at night is there are a lot of people my age that don't know what peace feels like. They don't know what freedom is like. They don't know how to leave a house and be sure that they will return because everything is up in the air. They leave their houses and they're not sure if they're going to return.
Well, that's true for all. It is most acute for women.
The sentiment is from the Taliban regime, they're saying we're Taliban 2.0 and we're okay with women. We're going to let them get education. We're different. We've learned a lot from when we were in power the last 20 years. I don't think anybody believes them.
Reports came today that women news anchors have been taken off Afghan TV. Amina's female cousins are in hiding, as they just 2 weeks ago were in government jobs, surgeons. They weren't adults when the Taliban was last in power.
A lot of the younger generation in Afghanistan that are 20 years old, 18, 19, 20 right now, they also don't know how to live like her. So for them to go from almost one extreme to another is going to be very difficult, and I'm not really sure how they're going to do it.
Unsure there and here, watching every moment of there.
What's the last week been like?
Emotionally roller coaster. I feel like things unraveled so fast. I'm still trying to process things emotionally.
So Amina says her plans right now is to stay in constant contact with her mom and her cousins and try to get her mom on any flight out of Kabul or Qatar. And as for Amina, she's volunteering to help states like Minnesota or Wisconsin, offering to welcome refugees as an interpreter.